He was known as Hitler's personal prisoner. He was a young barrister, German obviously, Jewish ancestry, who 2 years before Hitler had come to power had decided to put Hitler on the stand and subject him to this incredibly searing cross-examination in a Berlin court. 2 years after, that is when Hitler seized power in Berlin, Hans Litten was one of the first political targets to be taken that night. He was sent from one German concentration camp to another. Adolf Hitler had never forgotten that horrible experience in a German court.
At the time, he probably didn't realise how brave he was. He was a very, very brilliant young advocate. He was only 32. And he believed in what he was doing. It's very rare that you get a script with as beautifully written as this, for a start. And the story was completely unknown to me. I hadn't heard of Hans Litten. I'd never heard of Irmgard Litten, so it was an eye-opener. And plays like this remind one what a democracy is. And I think what Irmgard can't believe and outrages her is the fact that there is such a thing as democracy and law and order and freedom of speech and all those things that we hold and take absolutely for granted here. Irmgard's particular situation is one that will touch a lot of women, I think, because it is a mother's view of things. They will do anything. It has affected people a great deal. And also fathers, funnily enough. There was a man who came up to me who said, Fritz's last speech, where he said, I knew my son as a young boy, but as he grew up, I lost him. And he said, I feel rather guilty. He felt the same. He felt rather guilty about his not understanding this grown man and how the mother understood the child but respected the man he was growing into. And that has been very prevalent. I'm very lucky to have met Mark and have this wonderful play to do. It's most brilliantly written, and I can't believe my luck. You can't make people feel things they don't want to feel. An audience will have to come and see how they feel about it.
Today, I think it speaks about the enduring struggle, which is a political struggle, and the enduring love that mothers especially, maybe it's not to say fathers as well, but it's the mothers who put up the front line, have for the children who are disappeared by a regime. That, to me, that's a very important story.